To enjoy the winter and the snow, you don't necessarily have to ski or snowboard. In fact, snowshoeing is a great and fun way to enjoy the snowy outdoors in your own rhythm. It's perfect for beginners, any age and fitness level. If you can walk, you can definitely snowshoe. So today we're going to snowshoe together with Agnieszka, who is a mountain leader and a climbing instructor living here in the beautiful French Alps. Agnieszka is going to share with us some useful tips that you should keep in mind before you head into your first snowshoeing in the mountains. And now maybe you can explain me and the people who never done snowshoe, what is the actual snowshoe thing? Like, what is this thing?
The snowshoe helps you to not sink in the snow and holds you on the surface. Snowshoe is giving you the access to the places you cannot go without in the snow.
And where do I get it from? Should I buy one or should I rent one?
If you think you will do it regularly, I think you can. It's a good idea to have it. And you find them in any sport shops. And you can rent it in the ski shops if you are in the ski resort. If you are doing the snowshoe with the guide, you have to ask, because sometimes they provide the snowshoe.
And they also provide the poles, right?
Yes, they provide the poles and the snowshoes. The poles are important, really, because they help you to keep the balance. When you are not in the flat place, it's really helpful.
So you said that there is no special technique, really? I can walk whatever, however I want?
There is no special technique. But you have to know how to react when it's going up and when it's going down. But on the flat places, it's not technical at all. Some people ask why the heel is not attached to the snowshoe. If you attach the heel, you cannot bend your knee. So you're walking like a penguin.
Like a penguin. So what should I pack and wear to the snowshoe?
Today, as you see, it's a really nice day,
sunny.
Warm, sunny, but when you go to the mountain, you need to be prepared for all situations. It's better to have many layers rather than big jackets. You need a jacket anyway, but it must be waterproof and a light one. I think this one looks good.
Thank you.
If you can have a technical sweatshirt, it's great. If not, it's just like pullover.
Or a t-shirt,
yes, you can see we are in the middle of the winter.
Quite warm.
Warm.
Yeah. Like a ski or snowboard pants.
Snowboard pants. So this is one option. I always have, you know, like a light one, and I have a leggings underneath. Because we are in altitude, it's important really to think about sunglasses and sunscreen, because the snow is reflecting the light and it's dangerous for your eyes and for your skin. But the weather in the mountain changed very quickly. It can get cold and cloudy and snowy. So we have to be prepared for it and have in our backpack things like a hat, scarf, gloves.
So do you need any kind of professional boots or something?
It's not like a professional boots, but it's mountain boots. So your high boots are, mountain boots are really good. Most of the time they are waterproof.
And also have to be comfortable, because
and
if you go for
of course.
4 hours,
sure.
Should be.
Sure. Yeah. The backpack is very important. In the backpack you will have also your water. It's good to think about your thermos and have a nice cup of tea. And don't forget to put some snacks, because we are in the afar and it can come quickly to feel like...
You need some boost.
Yeah.
So if I'm a beginner and I've never tried snowshoe before, can I do it just by myself, or should I join like an organizing excursion?
If you used to be in the mountain, to walk in the mountain, like hiking, it could be possible. There are some places where you can find the
signs,
like, the signs for snowshoes. So they are prepared by the ski resort. When you take these paths with signs, you will be safe if you stay in the path. You don't have to go to the right, to the left to see the landscape, because there is a place, you know, you think you will see better. And then when you lose the path, then it can start to be tricky.
There is danger of basically what?
Yes,
like avalanches?
You can find yourself in not a good place, like avalanche risks. When the weather change and then there is no visibility, you can get lost, really. Follow the signs. Have your watch with you, and days are short in the winter. So you have to get back
before it gets dark.
And don't forget to tell somebody Where are you going? And when do you think you will be back? Most of the guides are living in the areas. They are able to show you the places you will not find by yourself, like the special ones with a special view. He will provide you the transport. He will provide you the snowshoes. He will take you to the places where it's better to go when it's sunny, where it's better to go when it's snowy. The guide has always lots of story to tell you about the places, about the trees, about the snow, because the snow is life element. Of course, animals' life, the winter animals' life is very interesting, it's different. We don't see animals often in the forest, but there are some places where we can observe the animals who are living higher in the mountain, like ibex, like chamois.
Maybe rabbits.
Rabbit is really difficult to see. Really. You know why? Because it's white in the winter. It's changing color, so it's white in the winter and you don't see the rabbit on the snow. If you are looking for some adventure with special traditional meal in a hut in the mountain, the guides knows those places well. The best ones, of course. One of most important thing with the guide is that those guys are here because they love the place. And they have a special sensitivity in the nature. They will open your eyes on things you never imagined they are there. It can bring you a different perspective and maybe inspire you to go and discover more and more.
It's getting colder, windy.
So Agnieszka, I met you 2 years ago on a snowshoeing trip. It was a part of a yoga retreat in the mountains. I actually like the connection of yoga and snowshoeing. Maybe you can explain it in a few words where yoga and snowshoeing can come together.
I think that in both of those activities, you connect to yourself. The snowshoeing allows you to go fast or go slowly. When you walk, you have to breathe. You have no choice, but you can connect to this. And then it starts to be interesting. It's as when you do yoga. When you walk, you really focus on your breathing, on your steps. It's surprising to discover this connection with the nature, but with yourself, with all the senses, with the sounds you hear, with the smells. That keeps you here at the present moment. You find kind of harmonious moment. I always ask people to try to not chat, and it changes everything. If you are by yourself, it's difficult to keep the focus. You always go somewhere, thinking about the work, the children, what will you prepare to eat this evening. So the guide is good to always bring your focus on where you are, what you are doing. Look at this tree, look at this color, look at this shape, breathe.
And the view.
And the view, voila. When the snow is fresh, it's so beautiful to walk in this, to put your line on it. But we have lots of fun, actually. We choose always the places where we can slide on snow. So we are really sliding and we are having good fun. The joy is also to just be in this beautiful moment and to share the moment
with
nice people.
Thank you so much, Agnieszka. I hope you liked this video and you found some useful tips for your snowshoeing. So if you want to experience the snowshoeing, get in touch with Agnieszka and come here to the beautiful French Alps. Bye!